Host of the sense organs, all the faculties, lingatmana, ekibhavati, all of that becomes one or merged into the subtle body. So all of these are amsha, the fractions of the subtle body, and subtle body is amshi. So all the amsha, the fractions, merge into the principal source. Tadyanam parsvastaha ho na pasyatiti. That is how the people sitting around say, he does not see. And similarly also, na jighati na rasayate, and so forth and so on. So people around see that one after another faculties are being lost. Tada upalakshate devata nivrittihi karanam chardaye eki bhavaha. So from this two things are upalakshate, two things are indicated. One is devata nivrittihi. Then the devata, respective devata, the presiding deity, has withdrawn its favor upon that particular sense organ. And karanam budaye cheki bhavaha, and that sense organ has merged into the subtle body. These two phenomena are what are indicated by this description. So eki bhavati na pashyati, two things are said. Eki bhavati na pashyati iti ahuhu. Eki bhavati karanam sau linge eki bhavaha. That the sense organs are merged into the subtle body, and na pashyati, he does not see, that means the devata has withdrawn its anugraha. These are the two things that are, that's what is happening. Tat rudaye upasamhrateshu karaneshu ya antarvyaparaha sahakathyate. So when all these karana, the sense organs, are all withdrawn into the heart, then what is the vyapara, the activity, inner activity that takes place, is also being stated by the Shruti. Tasya prakritasya hrudayasya agram pradyodate, hrudaya chidrasya agram pradyodate. Then the agra, the tip of the hrudaya chidra, the tip of the aperture in the heart, which is the imam, which is the path, so which is a way for him to depart, so that pradyodate, that brightens up. Svapna kala eva svena bhasa tejo matra adana krutena Sveneva Jyotisha Atmanaeva Cha Tinatma Jyotisha Jyotish Pradyotanena Vraya Agrena Esha Atma Vijnanaha Lingopadi Nirgachati Nishkranati. Which means that a specific vritti arises at this time. What is meant by the brightening up of the passage in the heart is that a specific vritti arises there. So Bhavi Deha Vishekena Vijnana Saha Vartamanaha. So Vijnanam, the specific knowledge, Visheshajnanam, Bhavi Deha Vishekena. So the specific knowledge pertaining to the next embodiment is what happens at that time. So even though it is said that the mind and intellect and all of these are merged in the subtle body, we will say that the intellect is not totally merged in as much as due to the karma and all the bhavanas that this person has entertained during the whole life. So the end result of this, or the sum total of all these bhavanas, the thoughts that are entertained, they arouse a certain vritti, a certain thought form in the mind, which pertains to the next embodiment. And that very thought is again illumined by the Atma, the Self, which is the consciousness. So two kinds of lights are being stated. Svena bhasa, Svena Jyotisha. Svena bhasa, by his own luster, which means by the luster of the nature of the vrittis that are aroused because of the vasanas, and Svena Jyotisha, by his own light, which is the light of consciousness. So just as in the dream, the vasanas bring up a whole set of the vrittis which create the dream world, and the dream objects of the dream vrittis are entertained by the consciousness, so something similar to that happens here at the time of death. And sa vijnana, vijnanena sa, along with this vijnana, the atma departs from this body. So idea is that the departure of the atma is only with reference to the vijnana, that's all. Departure of the atma is not in the primary sense, but departure of the atma is sort of figuratively said to be on account of the departure of the subtle body, where this vijnanam or the specific knowledge has happened. Tatha asarvane kasminam utkrande utkranda bhavishyami kasminva pratishthite pratishthasyami. So Bhashyakara presents a number of evidences to show that it is subtle body that really departs. Then there is such a thing called subtle body. And that is what enters and that is what departs. And therefore the entry and departure is not primarily applicable to Atma, it is primarily applicable to the subtle body. And that is then attributed to Atma. So there is something called subtle body, which is referred to as prana in the Prashna Upanishad. Kasmin aham utkrante utkranta bhavishyami. By the departure of which will I depart, and by the staying of whom which I will stay. Tatra cha atma chaitanya jyotihi sarvada abhivyaktataram. So it is never that the question is, when all the faculties are folded up, does it mean that there is no more subtle body, no manifest subtle body, or that Atma is no more with the upadhi? So this is lingopadhi atma natarhi tada or sada. You can't say that all the time the Atma is possessed of the upadhi of the subtle body, because at this time the subtle body seems to all fold up. So Vashyakara says, tatra cha atma chaitanya jyotihi sarvada abhivyaktataram. The subtle body is always illumined by, or is always enlivened by, the Atma Jyoti, or the consciousness that is a self. Tudupahadi dvara hi atmani janma manana gamana gamanadi sarva vikriya lakshana samvyavahara. It is only on account of this subtle body that all this samvyavahara, this vyavahara that is Atma, janma manadi, of the nature of birth and death, gamana gamanam, coming and going, all this vyavahara is said to be taking place in the Atma only on account of the upadhi of the subtle body. Tadatmakam hi dvadasavidham karanam buddhyadi tat sutram tat jivanam saha antaratma jagataha tastushascha. Tadatmakam hi dvadasavidham karanam. So what is this subtle body? Consisting of these 12 elements, 5 elements of perception, 5 elements of action, the mind and the intellect. Dvadasavidham karanam. So that is also, that basically is karanam, or is the means or the instrument. The subtle, the gross body is called the karyam, the subtle body is called the karanam. Tat sutram, that is called sutra. Vayurvai Gautama tat sutram. That vayu, which is the vital energy, which is here the subtle body, that alone is sutra. So that is what holds the entire universe together. Tat jivanam, and that alone is in fact what sustains the prana, therefore that alone is called jivanam. Jagataha jivanavi tatra manam, that the gross body is alive, that also shows, so that the gross body is alive and the gross body is dead, that shows that there is a factor which is responsible for the life in the gross body, and that is the subtle body. Tat jivanam saha antaratma. So yesha sarvabhuta antaratma, this one is antaratma, the indwelling self of all. So this is how also, thus Upanishads refer to the subtle body in different ways. Antaratma, sutram, jivanam, linga, in these different ways we find the subtle body or prana. Subtle body is referred to in the Upanishads. So we are on the page 1188. Then Anandagiri says, Lingopadehe Atmanaha Yathokta Prakashena Marana Kale Hrudaya Nishkramane Margam Prashnapurukam Uttaravakyena Upadishati. So all of this discussion establishes that Atma is always Lingopadehe. So wherever linga of the subtle body is there, it is always illumined by the Atma, then the consciousness always gets reflected in the subtle body, and therefore Atma is always possessed of the subtle body. So whenever Atma manifests in his life or in any name and form, the subtle body must be there. As when Atma manifests as sentient being, then the subtle body must be there. Lingopadehe Atmanaha Yathokta Prakashena. So Yathokta Prakashena, that Pradyodate, that brightens up, the tube of the heart brightens up. That's the Prakasha of the nature of Vritti or thought form that takes place, illumining the Bhavi Deha, so illumining the future embodiment. यथोक्त प्रकाशन मरण काले हृदया निष्क्रमण एट द टाइम टाइम ऑफ डेथ हृदया निष्क्रमण सो विन दिस आत्मा विद उपाधि ऑफ सटल बॉडी डिपार्ट फ्रॉम द हार्ट मार्गम प्रश्नपूर्वकम उत्तरवाक्यन उपदिशति सो व्हाट इज द मार्ग व्हाट्स द पाथ ऑफ द पैसेज थ्रू विच द आत्मा डिपार्ट्स सो दैट पैसेज उपदिशति द श्रुति टीचर्स और भाष्यकार टीचर्स प्रश्न पूर्वकम एज प्रिसीडेड बाय ए प्रश्न और अ क्वेश्चन तेन इत्यादि भाष्यकार सेस तेन प्रद्योतेन हृदयाग्र प्रकाशेन निष्क्रममाणः केन मार्गेण निष्क्रामते इति उच्यते तेन प्रद्योतेन हृदयाग्र प्रकाशेन सो हृदयाग्र द टिप ऑफ द हार्ट सो द टिप ऑफ द हार्ट दैट इज दस इल्यूमिन्ड और ब्राइटन निष्क्रमणः सो द आत्मा इज डिपार्टिंग अलोंग विद दिस लाइट लाइट इज नथिंग बट दैट वृत्ति स विज्ञानो भवति आत्मा डिपार्ट अलोंग विद दैट विज्ञानम और द नॉलेज सो ब्राइटनेस इज ओनली इन टर्म्स ऑफ दैट नॉलेज And it goes away along with the Atma. No one remains here. So, tena pradyodena hrudayagra prakashena saha nishkramamanaha. Atma that is departing along with this, along with the light of the nature of the vritti, nishkramamanaha, the one who is departing, kena margena nishkramati. By what passage, which passage does he leave? Uchyate, this is what Shruti answers. So prasnapurukam uttaravakyena upadeshati. The following passage is upadesha on the part of the Shruti. As to which is the passage by which the Atma lives. And so that is being said here. Chakshushtova adityaloka praptanivittam jnanam karmava yadisyad murdnova ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्त निमित्तं चेत् अन्येभ्यो वा शरीरदेशेभ्यः शरीरावयवेभ्यः यथा कर्म यथाश्रितम् चक्षुष्टो वा सो आईज कन्वे द पैसेज फुटनोट नंबर 8 चक्षुर्द्वारा आईडिया इज दैट through the gate of the eyes. Now, when does that happen? Says Ananagiri, Chakshushtovayati vikalpe nimittam suchayati. So, what's the reason why this Atma, so sopadika Atma, depart from the passage of Chakshu, the eyes? So, nimittam suchayati. Bhashyakara indicates what nimitta or what cause can be there. Adityadi. Adityaloka praptanivittam jnanam karmavaya disyat. The idea is that the Atma will merge into the deity from where it departs. So if Atma departs from the passage called the eyes, he will go to Adityaloka. So Adityaloka praptanivittam jnanam. If this person has performed the upasanas and rituals which will qualify him to reach the world of the sun, then he will depart from the eyes. And Murdnovati Vikalpahetumaha. And when it departs from the Brahmarandra, from the aperture in the head, Murdnova, Brahmarandra Dwara, through the Randra, through the Chidra, the aperture in the Brahma, so in the head, in the crown rather, so from the aperture in the crown, Murdnova, Brahmaloka Praptanimittam Chayad. And if he has performed the upasanas and rituals which will qualify him to go to Brahmaloka, then he will depart from this Brahmarandra, from this aperture in the crown. Sri Dhanagi, tat prapta nivittam che jnanam karma vasyat iti purvena sambandha. If there is a upasana or the ritual which would qualify him to attain that Brahmaloka. Tat prapti is brahmaloka prapti nimittam. Deha avayavantare bhya nishkramane niyamakamaha. And what is the determinants? Niyamakam. What is the determinants? What other passage he will leave from? Yatha iti Bhashyakara says, so anyebhyo va sharira deshebhyah. Or he will leave from other passages also of the body. Sharira avayavebhyah, shrotra adibhyah sakasa, from the shrotra etc. and other passages. Yatha karma yatha shrutam, that comes from the Kathopanishad. Yatha karma yatha shrutam. Yoni manye prapadyande shariratvaya dehinah. So some jivas leave for the yoni, for their embodiment. Shariratvaya, so shariratvaya dehinah. For another sharir or embodiment, they go. Or sthanu manjenu sanyanti. Some others only attain the embodiment of sthanu. That means immobile embodiment they get. Like the trees and so forth. Yatha karma, yatha shrutam. According to the karma and shrutam in Supasara. Then Mahasakara continues. Tam vijnanatmanam utkramantam paralokaya prasthitam paralokayodbhutakutam ityartha pranah sarvadhikaristhaniyo rajnyaiva anutkramate tamcha pranam anutkramantam vagadeha sarve pranah anutkramante tam putnan varu rajasthaniyam vijnanatman utkramantam. So when the atma with the upadhi subtle body, when he departs, so he is like the king. So he is the one that leads, you know. So rajasthaniyam, so like the king that is in the right at the head of the whole procession. So similarly also, the atma that departs is the head of the whole procession. Tam vijnanatmanam utkramantam. Utkram paralokaya prasthitam. So dhanagiri kadam katham paralokaya prasthitam idi uchyate. Footnote 12. Prasthitam vijnanatmanam anu prana utkramate idi katham uchyate ityarthah. That prana follows the vijnanatma, the jivatma. How is that being said? So katham paralokaya prasthitam idu uchyate prana gamana adhinatvad vijnanatma gamanasthiti ashinkyah. Hey, we find that the prana leaves first and then the vijnanatma leaves. How do you say that the atma first leaves and then the prana leaves? Usually we find the prana leaves and then there is no sentience here. So prana gamana adhinatvad vijnanatma gamanasya, that we say that the atma has departed from this body when really prana departs. And here it is said that the atma first departs and prana follows that. So anyway, paralokaya udbhutakutam ityartha. This is what is meant by, so utkramantam paralokaya prasthitam. That atma is now ready to depart from the next world or the next embodiment. Paralokaya udbhutakuta vijnanam. Footnote number 3. Prakatida abhiprayam. So udbhuta akuta. Akuta means abhiprayam. Udbhuta prakatida. So udbhuta akutam. So prakatida abhiprayam. So paralokaya udbhuta akutam. So one whose abhipraya, the intention of what the next embodiment is going to be, is prakatidam, is evident. So one for whom the next embodiment is evident, that one departs from the from this body. So that is why we say that atma leaves first, because that is where the knowledge first takes place. Then pranaha sarvadhikarasthaniyah rajnyaiva. Just as a king, sarvadhikarasthaniyah, footnote number 4, mantristhaniyah. So there may be a prime minister, the king. So when the king departs and then the prime minister will follow him. So prana, so prana is in the sense, in the place of the, like the prime minister. So that's how in Aitareya Upanishad and so forth it is described now, that prana is a servant, the primary servant of the atma. So atma enters from the top passage and the prana enters from the bottom passage, that is from the right toe of the right leg, toe of the right leg. So prana sarvadhikarasthaniha rajmiha anutkramati abhipraya manasatya kramati. Prime minister, the minister is the one who knows the abhipraya of the king. It's not that king even has to announce it. He knows the abhipraya, the intention of the king, and when that intention is arisen in the king, and when the king acts accordingly, then the minister knows and he also will follow. So prana also, who has known now the intention of the atma who wants to depart, he also follows. So anutkramati. Abhiprayamanusrutya kramati. Anutkramati. Anutkramati. So anu means anusrutya, following, utkramati. So he also departs. Tamcha pranam anutkramantam. There must be mind there. Tamcha pranam anutkramantam. And when this prana, who is in the place of the minister, when he departs, vagadaya parivarasthaniya, other members, you know, other members of the group or the family, they also follow. Vagadaya sarve prana anutkramanti. So first the king, and then the minister, and then the rest of the retinue, they all follow them in sequence. Then Anandiji says, this is quite interesting, you know, like a procession going on, you know, one after the other. So is that how it happens? Nanu jivasya pranaditadatmya sati katham anushabdena kramo vivakshate. Nanu, footnote number 13. Nanu ityadi atra vartikam. Nanvatma pranavagadehe anyonyam jatimishranat deshikaladya sambhedat kramenotkramanam kathamidi. So nanu atma pranavagadehe anyonyam jatimishranat. In fact, you cannot distinguish this. Actually, it has been said that all the faculties have been withdrawn in the subtle body. And so the faculties are not really, they do not stand apart from the subtle body. And the subtle body is the upadhi of the atma, therefore, subtle body also does not stand apart from the atma. So, atma prana vagadehe, atma and prana and the speech and all of the faculties, anyonya vyati mishranat, all of them are merged into or mixed with each other. Deshikaradi asambhedat. Therefore, it is not that they are separated from one another in space or in time. Kramena utkrama katham. Then how does Shruti describe your utkrama or departure in a krama, in a sequence? So, tika kandiya mithas tadatmavetam sahaye gamanam nyayam iti bhavaha. So those who become so tadatmavetam, those who have identified with one another, so merged into one another, so naturally they must depart together. And this description, the description of part of the Shruti, that they are departing in a sequence, doesn't seem to make sense to us. So keeping that in mind, says Anandagiri, nanu jivasya pranadi tadatmesati. So from the previous description, it is clear that at this time jiva, the atma, is identified with the prana, and there the subtle body, and then the sense organs, all of these are merged into one. And he has withdrawn all these faculties and entered into the heart, and then he is departing from there. That means that all of these are merged into one another. Katham anusabdena kramo vivakshate anutkramanti. Or anutkramati. So anu means anusrutya utkramati. Anusrutya. Anusaranam. So following that is also depart. How come that krama or the sequence is being intended to be said here? Tatraha yatha pradhana yadi. So Vashyakara says, yatha pradhana anvachikhyasa yam natukramena sarthavata गमनम इह विवक्षितम। यथा प्रधान अन्वाचिख्यासा इयम् श्री आनंद गिरि यथा प्रधान प्रधानम अनतिक्रम्य इयम् अन्वाचिख्यासा अन्वाख्यानेच्छा सो अन्वाख्यातमिच्छा अन्वाचिख्यासा चिख्यासा मीन्स ख्यातमिच्छा आख्यातमिच्छा सो आचिख्यासा सो प्रधानम अनतिक्रम्य The idea is that that is pradhana, the principal one. So another kramya, keeping in that limit of the principle, that is keeping the principle as a principle. So not transgressing the idea of the one that is principle or important, not transgressing the idea of importance. Yam anvakhyanecha. This akhyana. So this description of the Paradashruti is only keeping in mind what is principle. And so in that is why the hierarchy has been described, the hierarchy of importance has been described. Natu kramena sarthavat gamanam. So Sri Ranagi Tathacha Jivadehe Pradhanya Viprayana Anushabda Prayogaha. Tathacha. So the footnote 15. Anvakhyanechaya Pradhanya Anurodhitvecha. So this anvakya, this akhya, or this description of the part of the Shruti is pradhanya anurodhitve, is only in keeping with the pradhanyam, in keeping with the importance. So this description of the part of the Shruti is only in keeping with the importance of the various faculties in the body. Jivadehe pradhanya abhiprayana. Footnote 16, pradhanya di. Jivasya pradhanyam, pranasya gunatvam, tasya pradhanyam, vagadyanam gunatvam vidhi abhiprayana. That jiva is pradhana. So jiva is the principal one and the prana is the secondary one. Then prana is the principal one, other faculty are secondary one. So this is the abhipraya. So jiva dehe. Not only, so jiva is the pradhana, all right. So principal one. The prana is subservient. Then prana becomes principal, other faculties become subservient. That's why jiva dehe, the adi is there. Pradhanya abhiprayana anusabda prayogaha na krama abhiprayana. So anutkramati, anutkramanti, etc. The anu is not to indicate necessarily a sequence, but to indicate which is the principal one and which is the subservient, secondary one. न क्रम अभिप्रायण देश काल भेद अभावात् सो फुटनोट 7 इज एकस्मादेव देशात् एकस्मिन्नेव काले सर्वेषां निर्गमादिति भावः यावत् एकस्मादेव देशात् फ्रॉम वन प्लेस एकस्मिन्नेव काले सो व्हेन देयर इज अ डिपार्चर फ्रॉम अ गिवन पैसेज द होल होस्ट ऑफ थिंग्स डिपार्ट्स टुगेदर Not that Atma departs from one passage and other people depart from other passages. They all depart from the same passage. So, ekasmadeva desha. From one place alone or one aperture alone, the departure is. Ekasminneva kale. At one time alone, the departure is. Sarvesham nirgamat. And so, desha kala bheda abhavat. In short, in that departure, there is no bheda. Or no difference in desha, the place from where they depart, and kala, the time when they depart, they being the same, the krama is not intended here. Sarthavat gamanam, siddhanagi, sarthe samuhe, vyaktishu, kramena gamanam drishyate. So when there is a group of people, then you find that the going or movement is in a certain sequence. Depending upon, you know, which is the principal one that always leads and the second one follows. That's called sartha. Sartha means a party or a company or a samuha or a group. So, natu kramena sarthavad gamanimha vivakshitam. Even if a group of buffaloes and cows and whatever, you find them generally, they all follow, you know, in a certain sequence, one after the other. But that is not what is intended here. सार्थे समूहे व्यक्तिषु क्रमेण गमनम दृश्यते न तथा प्राणादिषु इति व्यतिरेक है, व्यतिरेक दृष्टांत है. सो सार्थ बिकम व्यतिरेक दृष्टांत है. सो दैट इज वेयर यू फाइंड दी मूवमेंट और डिपार्चर इन अ क्रम और इन सीक्वेंस, नॉट लाइक दैट हियर. अनलाइक सो अनलाइक दी मूवमेंट इन ए ग्रुप, दैट इज नॉट द केस हियर. यदुक्तं हृदयाग्र प्रद्योतनम् तत्सविज्ञानश्रुत्या प्रकटयति. सेम थिंग, यदुक्तं हृदयाग्र प्रद्योतनम्, दैट देयर इज अ ब्राइटनिंग अप ऑफ द ट्यूब ऑफ द हार्ट, तत्सविज्ञानश्रुत्या सविज्ञानो भवति. सो दिस इज व्हाट सविज्ञानश्रुत्या, दिस स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द श्रुति सविज्ञानो भवति, दैट अगेन रिफर्स टू द सेम ब्राइटनिंग अप, सविज्ञानो भवति. भाष्यकार तदा एष आत्मा सविज्ञानो भवति स्वप्ने इव विशेष विज्ञानवान् भवति कर्मवशात् न स्वतंत्रः. तो एष आत्मा सविज्ञानो भवति. At this time when all of them are departing, this Atma becomes possessed of this Vijnanam. Vijnanam is Bhavideha Vijnanam, so knowledge of the future or the subsequent embodiment. Swapne Iva, as in the dream, Vishesha Vijnanavan Bhavati, footnote number 8, Bhavideha Vishayaka Jnanavan Bhavati. He becomes possessed of the knowledge of the next embodiment. Karma vasha, to on account of the karma, as determined by the karma. Na svatantraha. So Vashyakara now makes a point here that the vijnana or the awareness that this atma has of the next embodiment is brought to him by karma or the action, and not that he himself determines that. The jivatma does not determine what that vijnana will be. It is karma that determines what that vijnanam is going to be. So yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tejatyande kalevaram ante kalevaram tejati. So when he departs from his body, then yam yam vapi, whatever the bhava is there, tam tamevaiti kaunteya, that is the embodiment he gains. So this bhava that is here determines the shape of the body. That whole embodiment appears here in the form of a bhava. So it is from one bhava to other bhava he goes actually. But anyway, that bhava or that knowledge or the specific vijnanam becomes evident to him because of this, determined by the karma and not as something that is determined by himself. Na svatantraha. कर्म वशाद इति विशेषणं साधयति. कर्म वशाद एज डिटरमिन्ड बाय द कर्म. सो व्हाट इज मेंट बाय दैट इज न स्वतंत्रः, दैट ही डज नॉट हैव द फ्रीडम टू डिटरमिन व्हाट दैट विज्ञानम इज गोइंग टू बी. विपक्षे दोषम व्हाई नॉट, व्हाई नॉट दैट ही डिटरमिन्ड दैट देयर इज नो स्वतंत्रता एट दैट टाइम. हैड द स्वतंत्रता बीन देयर, व्हाट वुड हैव हैपेंड इफ द जीवात्मा वेर फ्री in determining what that next embodiment would be, what would have been the case? Svatantrena, says Vashyakara, Svatantrena hi savijnanatve sarvaha kratakratyasya naivato tallabhyate. Svatantrena hi savijnanatve sarvaha kratakratyasya. Everybody would be kritakritya. Footnote number 9. Marana samayi yasya jnanam taduttaratra labhyate tatra jnane svatantastu konam apakrushtam bhavayet brahmaiva atmanam bhavayetva muktasyadri bhavana. Marana samayi yasya jnanam taduttaratra labhyate. So whatever be the knowledge, that is what is attained at the end, later on. So subsequently, tatra jnane svatantastu, when one is svatantra or free, you know, in determining what that jnana is going to be, konama apakrushtam bhavayet, Who it is that will think of a mundane or a lower embodiment? Brahmayuva Atmanam Bhavayitva. In fact, he will want to determine that I am Brahma. This is the Vijnanam that he will want to have that time. Muktasyadivhavaha. He would rather become free. Having gone through all this pain and stuff like that, who will want now again to enter another, some kind of a mundane body or some kind of a lower upadhi and go through the process again? He will want to be liberated. Svatantrena hi savijnanatve sarvaha kritakritya syat. So one would become kritakritya, fulfilled in the life. Ishtapattim asankya, that sounds nice. Why not that way? Vasaka naivatu tallabhyat. Unfortunately, this is not what we find happening here. Tat kritakrityatvam naivalabhyate. But we don't find that kritakrityatvam being attained by the jivatmas, jivas, and therefore we say that this savijnanatvam is not svatantram, is karmavashat. And the English says, mumushoho asvatantre manamaha. Again, what's the evidence that you have that the mumushu or the dying person is a svatantraha? Is not free to determine. So it isn't the freedom to determine. Manamaha, the evidence is being said, ataha eva iti. Ataha eva aha vyasaha sada tad bhava bhavitaha iti. Ataha eva. So, footnote number 11. Tasya asvatantryadeva. On account of his freedom not being there, being dependent, that is, keeping that in mind, sage Vyasa is a Vyasa, you know. So, he said in the Bhagavad Gita. Now, Bhagavad Gita is a statement of whom, you know. So, Vyasa, sada tadbhava bhavitaha iti. And therefore, so he departs. So, the bhava at the end is determined by what he has entertained, the kind of thoughts he has entertained for the whole of his life. So that is what he attains, which is determined by the bhava, the kind of attitude that is entertained. So kind of attitudes, thoughts, desires, all of that is entertained throughout the life. So whatever be the principal kind of thoughts he has entertained, so that is what determines what his last thought is going to be. Page 1190, Sri Ramil, karma vashaduktam savijnanatvam upasamharati. So karma vashaduktam, that vijnana is determined by karma, upasamharati, Bhashyakara here now concludes that karmanayati. Karmana tad bhavyamanena antah karmanato udbhavyamanena antahkarana vritti vishesha ashrita vasanatmaka vishesha vijnanena sarvo lokaha etasmin kale sa vijnanu bhavati. So karmana to udbhavyamanena, it is karma that actually arouses udbhavyamanena antahkana vritti visheshasrita vasanatmaka vishesha vijnanena. That's explained by Anandagiri. So antahkana vritti vishesha, antahkanasya vritti vishesha. The specific thought that arises in the mind, or the mind assumes the form of a specific thought, antahkana vritti vishesha ashrita. So antahkana vritti vishesha is bhavi deha vishaya. So bhavideha, the future embodiment or the next embodiment, is the subject matter, the form of the antahkarana vritti. So tat ashrita, tad ashritam, tad rupam. So of the nature of that, yad vasanatmakam vishesha vijnanam. So that vishesha vijnanam is of the nature of vasana at that time, which is of the form of the future embodiment. So that knowledge also is not that he sees a body or something like that perhaps, but then we say that the vasana means the impressions. So next embodiment, that is, the whole next embodiment is there, maybe the whole next life is there, who knows, you know. At that point, in the form of that the thought. And so, that thought is nothing but the samskara, the potential of what the next life is going to be. So therefore, vasanadvagam vishesha vijnanam. The vishesha vijnanam, or the specific knowledge that takes place at the time of death, is the nature of vasana, which takes the form of the next embodiment, which is in turn aroused by the karma. So karmas arouse that bhava, vasana or bhava. So, and that is the kind of bhava that takes place at that time. Sarva lokaha etasmin kale savijnanam bhavati. So savijnanam bhavati. Every departing creature becomes possessed of the particular knowledge of the form of the next embodiment, which is in the shape of or the form of the vasana. So savijnana bhavati, savijnana meva anuvakramati. Sri Ranagiri, mriyamanasya savijnanatve sari atha siddham arthamaha. So when mriyamana means when the dying person is possessed of this knowledge, then he departs with that knowledge. Artha-siddham artha-maha. So what it amounts to is that when he becomes possessed of a specific knowledge at the time of death, then naturally when he departs with that knowledge. And so Vashyakara says, savijnanamevacha jantavyam anvavakramade anugacchade vishesha vijnanod bhasatam eva ityartha sa vijnanam eva. So along with that vijnanam, so gantavyam, gantavyam means what destination is to reach, anvavakravad anugacchati. So he goes to the next destination along with the vijnanam, the awareness of what the destination is going to be. And that awareness is only in the form of the thought, which is of the nature of vasana, aroused by the karma and the vijnanam of his life. Gantavyam, that means that he comes to this body with the knowledge that I have to go to this body. He departs with the knowledge, and that is why it is that knowledge that leads him to this specific destination where he has to reach. Elsewhere it is said the Udanavayu is the leader, you know, the Udanavayu leads. Elsewhere it is karma that leads. Svakarma dutena javena nitaha. So in Viveka Chodam we say, svakarma dutena javena nitaha. Svakarma duta. The karma itself becomes a duta or the messenger or the leader. So they are led by the leader or pilot of the nature of their own karma. Ayanti, niryanti, asa urdvamuchaihi. And so, goes up and down, urdhvamuchaihi. So, again and again, so adha urdhvamuchaihi goes down and up quickly, in succession. Ayati comes and goes as led by one's own karma. Sri Ranagiri, gantavyasya savijnanatvam vijnanashayatum vyashankya vishnasti vishesh vijnana bhasanam eva ityartha. So vishesh vijnana bhasanam gantavyam, that gantavya, the destination, that is illumined by the specific knowledge. Now say Ranagiri, prageva utkrantehe savijnanatvavadishvatehe tatparimaha. Utkrantehe prageva, even before the departure also, savijnanatvavadishvatehe tatparimaha. So, what is the intention? Savijnanatvavadishvatehe. This shruti, savijnanameva anvanutkramati. That he departs along with the knowledge. So what is the intention of the shruti? Why does shruti say that when he departs with this knowledge? Prageva utkrantehe savijnanatvadishrutehe. Hrudayagram pradyodate. The tube of the heart becomes brightened. And that is even before the departure. So what's the reason why the Shruti wants to say that this specific knowledge of his destination takes place even before the departure, at the time of departure? Tasmadavi, so Tatparya. Tatparya, the whole passage is now stated by Bhashyakara, Tasmadavi. Tasmat tatkale svatantyartham yoga dharmanu sevanam parisankhyan abhyasascha vishishta punyopachayascha shraddhadhanehi paralokarthivihi apramattehi kartavya ide. Tasmat tatkale mrutikale. Tasmat purushasya karmanusaritvam tatshabdartha. Tasmat, since purusha, so the departure of the purusha or jivatma is determined by karma. Therefore, since one does not have freedom to determine what that thought is going to be, inasmuch as that last thought is determined by the karma, therefore, tasmat sarveshu kaleshu mamanasmara yudhyata. That's a lesson. So whatever happens at the time of death is of course not something that you can determine. But the only way to determine what happens at the time of death is to live in a particular way. Tasmat sarveshu kaleshu mamanasmara yudhyata. And therefore, at all the times, may you remember me and perform your duties. Mayyarpita manobuddhi. If you remember me all the time, then your mind and the buddhi, both of them, when they are merged into me, mayyarpita manobuddhi, mame vaishyasi asamshayam. There is no doubt that you will reach me. Something like that Mahashakara says here. Mahashakara says in his own way, what is meant by sarveshu kaleshu anusmara? Lord Krishna elaborates that. Abhyasa yogi yuktena chetasa nanyagamina paramam purusham divyam yati pasam chintayan. Abhyasa yoga yuktena chetasa na anyagamina. The chetas, the mind that does not go anywhere else. Abhyasa yoga yuktena chetasa, the mind that is restrained by the practice of the abhyasa yoga. So all the time meditating upon that paramapurusha. And so the mind now does not go anywhere else. Chetasa na anyagamina paramam purusham divyam yadi anuchintayan. So at that time, what is it that is thinking? That param purusha is what is thinking. So anuchintayan paramam purusham yadi partha anuchintayan. What is that param purusha that he has been thinking all the time? Kavim puranam anushasitaram anuraniyam sam anusmare. Identifying with that, and therefore that is what again is a thought that happens at the last time, at the last moment. Prayana kale manasa achalena bhaktyayukto yoga balena chaiva achalena manasa prayana kale bhaktyayukta yoga balena cha yukta. One is endowed with the bhakti as well as the strength coming from yoga. So that is what Bhashyakara refers to here. Tasmat tatkale svatantyartham yoga dharmanu sevanam. Why yoga? Because that's how Lord Krishna describes there. So yoga balena seva. So svatantyartham, in order to gain what they call the swechamrityu, or gain a control over one's own death, to gain the svatantrata, to gain the freedom to determine what one's destination is going to be, and for that purpose, svatantyatam, yoga dharma anusevanam. So one must do the anusevanam, constantly performing this yoga. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. So to be able to dismiss all the thoughts, or to be able to control all the thoughts, to be able to make the mind free from the thoughts, and to engage the mind in whichever thought one wants. So that's a great siddhi. To be able to rid the mind of the thoughts that are unwanted, and to be able to focus the mind upon the thought that is wanted. That is the primary purpose of yoga. Chitta vritti nirodha. So yoga dharma, what is dharma? Tasya dharmaha yama niyama prabhutayah. Tesham anusevanam punah punah avartanam. So yoga dharma anusevanam. Chitta vritti nirodha. And for accomplishing the chitta vritti nirodha, the dharma, dharma means anga. Dharmaha angani. So for that chitta vritti nirodha, the anga, what one has to do is yama, niyama, asana, etc. So tasya dharmaha yama niyama prabhudaya, beginning from yama niyama, all of that. Tesham anusevanam punah punah avardhanam. And so again and again following, or again and again putting into practice this yama, niyama and all the various angas of the yoga. And that's how, attaining that yoga, chitta, vritti, nirodha, this is what one has to do. Then, parisankhyana abhyasascha. Parisankhyana abhyasa, yoga anusthanam again. So, parisankhyana abhyasa is yoga anusthanam. So, anusthanam is again, so actually practicing that yoga. Vishishta punyopayascha. Vishishta punyopayascha. Not only yoga, yoga sadhana anusthanam, but vishishta punya upacheha. One should deliberately earn or accumulate the vishishta punya, the specific virtuous deeds one should perform, and thus this virtue is what one must accumulate in one's account. Vishishta punya upayascha shraddha dhanaihi paralokardhabhi apramattahi kartavya. Shraddha dhanaihi. So those who have this Shraddha in Paraloka, Paraloka Arthabhi, who else will be interested in the Paraloka? So one is desire of Paraloka, because there is Shraddha, there is a Paraloka. There is also Shraddha that the next birth is, that there is a next birth, Paraloka. And that the next birth is determined by the last thought that happens at this, in this birth. And the last thought that happens in this birth is determined by the thought that I am entertaining while I am alive. So that Shraddha one has. And therefore, paralokārthami, one who wants to make sure that the paraloka, so one attains a desirable next world. This preparation for the next world is very important in India. So everybody wants to, in Ramayana, Ramcharitmanas, all along you see that a person will actually go through a lot of tapascharya here, lot of pain and lot of mortification, suffering, so that the paraloka, the next life is assured that is going to be a virtuous life, or next life is going to be a happy life. So they will want a place in swarga, and for that they will do anything here. Anything means that they will undergo any kind of a penance here. That means invite the suffering here and deny all the pleasures in order that they get that the swarga loka. So for the sake of the paraloka, the sacrifice of this loka is not uncommon. It was not uncommon in India. Nowadays it is gone. Nobody cares for paraloka. Therefore, this loka is what counts. And that's the reason why the life has become just vasana anusari. Like, so, khao piyo maja karo. Eat, drink and make merry. This is, because nobody bothers about paraloka. So what is it? KPM. That is the medicine, you know. And so, KPM is a medicine, that's all. Shraddha dhanaihi paralokārthabhi apramattaihi. So apramatta. So those who are alert and those who are alive, and so apramattaihi kartavya. So people are alert and vigilant. So this is what they must do. Kartavya heti prakruta shrutehe vidheya arthaheti shesha. So kartavya, then we should add that. Iti prakruta shrutehe vidheya artha. Abhipretaha artha. So this is the artha of the meaning intended by the Shruti, when the Shruti describes the death in this manner. That this is how the death happens. May you know that. And therefore, you may want to determine how you want to die, and if you want to determine how you want to die, then you must live a certain way of life. So here I have a footnote which you do not have. Tatkale svapnavat paradhinam jnanam. At that time of death, svapnakale svapnavat paradhinam jnanam. Just as I do not have the freedom to determine what my dream is going to be, it is my thought that is aroused by the karma that determines. Similarly also at time of death, it is my karma that arouses the thought and that determines what that thought is going to be. Svadhina dhyaya devata jnana siddhyartham. So dhyaya devata jnana siddhyartham. In order to attain that, at that time I wish that, so Srinath Sriji Bhava, you know, that's what they will say. At that time, the knowledge that must take place is of the Ishta Devata. And so the bhaktas will always want that also, O Srinath Ji, may you appear before me. And so, what is it? Itana Dukarna Swami Jeva Pranatana Sanikle Govindanam Lekar. And so Vrindavan Kavataho Gangaji Kataho Mere Samara Nikataho. So and all this, so this is what they want to see. So Swadhina Dheya Devata Jnana Siddhyartham. For this to happen, so Dheya Devata Jnana Siddhyartham. That's the devata upon whom they have meditated all the time. And that is the knowledge that should arise at the time of death. For that, the swadhinata meaning the svatantrata should be there to determine that, to assure that. Yoga ja dharmanu sevanam yama niyama dehe. And therefore, yoga ja dharmanu sevanam. All the dharmas that are the anga of the yoga, yama niyamadehe tasa parisankhyabhyasa. This parisankhyabhyasa, Anagiri here said, parisankhyana abhyasa yoga anusthanam. This tika here says parisankhyabhyasa, although parisankhyana abhyasa, gadya rupe upadesha sahasri prabandhe ante parisankhya bhagavat padhi upadishta. In a text called upadesha sahasri, which is the 1000 upadesha by Bhashyakara, by Bhagavad Pada, so there it is both the Padya and Gadya, both are there in that particular text. The verse form also is there and the passages are also there. So Gadya Rupe Upadesha Sahasri Prabandhe, that Prabandha. Ante Parisankhya Bhagavad Pada hi Upadishta. At the end, Bhagavad Pada in fact has taught this Parisankhya. There is a parisankhyana prakaranam here, that's upadishta. Yathokta vijnanavadha kritakrityatvat na kinchid vidhitah anusthayam astidu upadidam tatridiyam vijnanavatam api keshanjit bhedarshana vasanavashat nirvadastha pradivad nischalam vijnanam nabhavadi tadatesham jnanadardhyaya parisankhyanam nama vakshamanam anuchintanam anusthayam upadeshtum arabhate. So, even vijnanavatam api, even those who possess this knowledge, keshanjit bhedadarshana vasanavashat. So, even though the knowledge of Veda is there, bhedadarshana vasanavashat on account of the vasana. So, strong impressions, so the strong tendencies of the mind which are there on account of bhedadarshanam, on account of the giving reality to duality so far. Nirvadastha pradivad nischalam vijnanam nabhavadi. If the knowledge doesn't become that abiding like a lamp, an unflickering lamp in a windless place, tadatesham jnanadardhyaya, for jnanadardhyaya, for firming up the knowledge, parisankhyanam nama vakshamanam anuchintanam anusthayam. Then the anuchintanam that the granthakara says here is what one must actually practice. So mumukshunam upatta punya punya kshapana paranam apurva anupacha arthinam parisankhyanamena muchyate. So in short, mukshanam, so the idea is that the Bhagavad Pada, that is Shankaracharya, also says there is parisankhyanam, this kind of practice is necessary in order that the mind gains an abundance. And so in this parisankhyanam prakaranam, this is what Bhashyakara also says all this. Avidya heto dosha vang manah kaya pravutti heto pravutti cheshta anishta mishra phalani karmani upachiyante iti tan moksha sam etc. Okay. So in short, Bhashyakara says here that the purpose of describing all of this and particularly stating that savijnanam, savijnana bhavati, avijnanavan bhavati, savijnanam eva anmanukramati, that it departs along with the vijnanam. The purpose is in a way to enjoin upon the seekers that they must lead a certain disciplined life and life that is devoted to the upasanas, to the meditations and to the worship and to the good actions and entertainment of good thoughts, so that the last thought also is of that nature. Then Sri Dhanagiri, kincha punyopache kartavyata rupe arthe sarameva vidhikandam parivasitam ityaha. Furthermore, punyopache kartavyata rupe arthe. Then the human life must be devoted to punyopache, in accumulating virtue, not in accumulating anything else. Although usually a human being spends life in accumulating wealth and whatever it is, but the scriptures recommend, or scriptures rather teach, or direct, or even enjoin, that one's life must be in accumulating punya virtue. In the process of accumulating punya, if other things come, then it's fine. It's not that there is any opposition or, you know, to wealth, etc. But then, if in the process of accumulating punya the wealth comes, fine, enjoy it. Doesn't come? Okay. But important is accumulation of punya. Kinja punya upachaya kartavyata rupe arthe. This is the prayojanam. Punya upachaya kartavyata. This is the kartavya of the human being. This is what the human being has to do, is to accumulate virtue. Sarameva vidhikandam parivasitam. So this is the purpose of all the vidhikandam. So there are two kandas in the Vedas. One is Vidhikanda or Karma Kanda, other is the Upanishad. So Bhashyakara shows here how the entire Veda teaches this. So Vidhikanda, meaning the Karma Kanda, only teaches us that how our life must be virtuous life. Vidhikandam parivasitam tatparyavata. That's the tatparya of the entire Karma Kanda. That's all. That punya upachaya. Iti aha sarva shastranamiti, says Bhashyakara. Sarva shastranam yatnatah vidheyorthah duscharitaccha uparamanam. Sarva shastranam yatnatah vidheyorthah yatnatah. All the shastras in fact exert themselves. And vidheha arthaha. And so the intended meaning or intended purpose of all the shastras, which they in fact reveal with a great exertion, is duscharitacha uparamanam, is cessation from duscharitra. Duscharitra means cessation from unbecoming behavior. That's all. Uparamanam yatnatah kartavya vidisheshah. This is what? That a human being must strive to cease from duscharita. Naveto duscharitat na shanto na samahitah na shantamanaso avi prajnane nina matmayat. This Kathopanishad said. So na duscharitat aviritah. One who does not cease from duscharita, from papa karma, from evil actions. So, well, unfortunately, whatever it is, the human tendencies are there. Human being is born with sattva, rajas and tamas, all the three gunas. And therefore, the point here is that one must submit to sattva guna and not to rajas and certainly not to tamas. Because in rajas, of course, there will be a mixture of punya papa and tamas will be papa. and sattva will be punya. And so so shastras in fact enjoin how we should lead a sattvic life. And for leading a sattvic life, it becomes necessary to subdue the impulses of rajas and tamas. So therefore they ask us to do certain things, that is called vidhi, and ask us to avoid certain, desist from certain things, that is called nisheda. Nisheda is how not to submit to the lower impulses, and vidhi is how to in fact strive to follow the noble impulses. So we must try to follow the noble impulses and with a determination desist from the submitting to the lower impulses. So this is the purpose of vidhi and nisheda, and this is the what the shastra does. Sarva shastranam yatnatah vidhehartah duscharitaccha uparamanam. Yatnatah kartavyam requires a lot of effort. So when we are talking about the yama, ahimsa and satya and asteya and aparigraha and so forth and brahmacharya, so we translate all of these in terms of non. Ahimsa means non-violence. So that is clear. Asteya means non-stealing, that is also is clear. Aparigraha, non-holding, because all of them start with a nine. But satya, satya means truthfulness. So we translate this non-falsehood. And brahmacharya means again self-control, so non-indulgence, this is what we say. This non, not doing, not doing. So naturally, in the West, when you say this, says no, this Swami, this is not right. This doesn't sound right. They teach us that we should tell them what to do. Don't tell children others what not to do. Don't do this, don't do this, don't tell them. Do this, do this, do this. Tell them what they should do. So why do the scriptures tell us non-violence, and non-falsehood and non-stealing? Why this non? We said because if this is not being said, person will do it anyway. Inasmuch as in this particular case, so when one has to do something good, then instruction is required. When one has to submit to one's lower impulses, no instruction is required. And since one will do this anyway, that's the reason why this is an instruction of not doing it. Because doing this is a natural impulse. Himsa is hurting is a natural impulse. And falsehood is a natural impulse. Stealing is a natural impulse. Indulgence is a natural impulse. These are all natural impulses born of rajas and tamas. And they were not do this, not do this. So all yama is only of the nature of nisheda. They are of the nature of don'ts. And niyama are of the nature of do's. So, yatnataha, kartavyam, all is effort to subdue one's natural impulses requires a lot of effort. Doesn't happen just like that. And every now and then they get better of us, you know. And then we also swept along with them. They take hold of us, they overpower us. And therefore, yatnataha, kartavyam, this is the idea here. Sri Dhanagri Sarvasmad Agami Duscharitad Uparamanam Kartavamiti Asminathe Nisheda Shastanapi Pariyavasitam Duscharitacha Uparamanam. So Vidheyartha and Nishidartha. Sarvasmad Agami Duscharitad. Whatever has been done. But Agami Duscharitad. At least in the future, that one does not submit oneself to this sinful behavior. The uparamanam, cessation from the sinful behavior, kartavyam, iti asminate nisheda shastanapi. So parivasitam, so nisheda, don't do this. So duscharitacha uparamanam. Two things the scriptures teach, what we should do and what we should stay away from doing. Now, puram yathesha cheshtam kritva marana kale saramvetat sampadayishyate. Why worry about it now? So, right now we can do whatever we want to do. At the time of death, we will determine what that thought should be. So, puram yathesha cheshtam kritva. So, before that, why not we do whatever we want to do? Marana kale, at the time of death, saramedat sambhadaishyade. That time all chitta vritti nirodhana, everything we will do. Why worry about it now? na ityah. No, that's not possible. So Bhashyakara says it. Nahi tatkale shakyate kinchit sampadayitum. Tatkale nahi kinchit sampadayitum shakyate. It is not possible to do anything at that time. At the time of death, nothing is possible. Krishna tvadiya padapangaja pinjarante adyayvameva satumana saradhyamsaha. So, prayer to Lord Krishna. Adyayvam, right now, me manas rajahamsaha, this rajahamsa, of the nature of my mind, so my mind which is like this rajahamsa, adyayva nivasatu, right now it may dwell in the cage of your lotus feet. So Lord Krishna, may it be that my mind, the hamsa, the swan of nature of my mind, may dwell in the cage of your lotus feet, adyayva now. So why worry about now? Why don't you do it at the time of death? Prana prayana samaye kafavada pittahi kanthavarodhana vidau smaranam kutaste. Prana prayana samaye, at the time of the death, when you are departing from here, the struggle is going on. Kanthavarodhana, so I can't repeat your name. Krishna, 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 I can't say kanthavarodhana vidau. That time my throat is choked up. And therefore, smaranam kutaste, how can I remember you? So will you please bless me or please shower your grace upon me that my mind now gets arrested in your lotus feet, doesn't go any place else. So this is the idea of this discussion here. Bhashyakara takes the opportunity, I guess, to say this. Rarely that he gets the opportunity to say this in Upanishad anyway. Oh. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamudachyate. Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmevi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadhyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om.